Progressive journalists and commentators that side with Sanders say the media is part of the problem here. And one of them is Cenk Uygur, the host, CEO, and founder of the online news show, The Young Turks. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me, Brian.
Why do you think it's wrong for the media to acknowledge the facts? The facts are the superdelegates are largely on Clinton's side, and they're probably not going to move based on the interviews we've done with them. Why is it wrong for the media to acknowledge that on Tuesday night?
Because they aren't facts at all. So first, let's just acknowledge what are actual facts, that the superdelegates do not vote until the convention. In fact, if they're not at the convention, their votes won't get counted at all, which
is almost never said on television. But the superdelegates are the establishment. They're all establishment people, and they're all voting for Clinton, only 46 for Sanders.
Now, Brian, you guys, and I mean CNN and all of the establishment press, totally tilted the playing field here from day one by counting those superdelegates, when in fact you know the superdelegates do switch their votes all the time. They switched it in 2008. Hillary Clinton had a 100 superdelegate lead, which completely vanished in 2008. So
was
why did you
wrong
count it from day one, which was absolutely incorrect? It was, in fact, journalistic malpractice. Why did you guys do that?
So you're saying more information is not a good thing. We should hide people from the reality of what the superdelegates are
doing. No. Brian, this is very important. If you say, hey, superdelegates are likely to vote this way, or they say they're voting this way, as an aside, that's perfectly fair. But if you count them in the official tally, when you know they can and often do switch their votes and have not voted yet, that is simply incorrect. That is not a fact. That is the opposite of a fact.
But the Hillary delegates switched because Obama was going to win. In this case, we know the superdelegates are establishment figures or former governors and people like that that are clearly pro-Clinton. Nothing's going to happen that's going to change their mind.
Again, not true. So, Brian, you say nothing's going to happen.
What's going to happen? Tell me.
I can tell you exactly what could happen.
Are you wishing for an indictment?
Superdelegates are for extraordinary... Hold on. They are for extraordinary circumstances. You know what would be extraordinary? If one of the candidates were indicted, of course. Mm-hmm. So you guys keep assuming there will be no indictment. And Brian, I hear you have reliable sources. Well, so tell me, do you have any sources inside the FBI or the State Department that have already told you that she is not going to get indicted? Because that would be news.
I do not. I cover media, not the FBI. But the indications at the moment are that she hasn't been interviewed by the FBI. I hear what you're saying about the indictment, but other than that, it seems to me you're misleading your audience, giving them more hope than they should actually have. You think about what's going to happen on Tuesday at 8 p.m. New Jersey's going to close.
That's
and
not
for the
true
first
at all.
Time in the history of this country, frankly, this is really exciting to say, but the first time in the history of this country, we're going to have a female nominee of a major party. I don't care if you're Republican or Democrat or Libertarian. That's something this country should note and acknowledge. And don't you think it's a shame that the Bernie Sanders talk is going to overshadow what we can all agree is a historic milestone?
I mean, look at the framing you just gave it, right? So I think Hillary Clinton is a completely pro-establishment candidate that will continue this corrupt system where private interests finance
their
elections.
But what about the historic milestone?
And so, but instead of looking at it as, hey, wait a minute, one guy hasn't taken that corrupting money and the other one has, you frame it as male versus female and hence put me in a position where I'm forced to say, no, I don't think it would be historic because I think it's the same old establishment, whether it's a male, a female, or anything else. So the framing is all biased. And I'm not saying that because I think that you're liberal or you're conservative, you're pro-Hillary or not. It's just the establishment told us from day one, the superdelegates have already voted when they did not, and you tell us today to, hey, make sure you go away and you support the establishment candidate. And you're wrong about how I've presented it on the show. I tell people about the delegate math all the time. And as Bernie Sanders himself acknowledges, it is an uphill battle for him to win more pledged delegates, a massive uphill battle, right? And I've said, and I've challenged Bernie Sanders on my program, and I said, look, if there are more pledged delegates on her side and there's no indictment, well, then that the race is over, right? Those are ifs, though. They have not happened yet. And the superdelegates vote at the convention. So for you guys to call it when you don't know what the circumstances are and those people have not voted yet, it is just simply incorrect. That is not journalism.
Cenk, thank you for being here. It is great talking with you. I appreciate it.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate that.
Coming up next here...